So if there were an accident like last Friday's, who do you call? 911, of course. And answering that call is a dispatcher call taker, a very stressful job, we know, and not one all of us is qualified to do.
And it's getting harder and harder to find people who want that job. KTAB's Jessica Rank finds that a nationwide shortage of dispatchers is having an impact on Abilene.
Abilene 911, what is the address of the emergency?
In some cases, they're the first line of defense.
Our dispatchers are the first responders.
Assisting in a time of crisis.
Okay, stay on the phone with me.
They answer calls from people who are having the worst day of their lives.
And lending a helping hand.
If at the end of the day you only help one person, then I think that's a good feeling.
The only problem, they're running in short supply. A nationwide staff shortage that Abilene Dispatch Communications Director Becky Makovich says is no different here in Abilene.
Our lowest overnight goes down to 5 in dispatch.
Technically fully staffed, but with 14 still in training, things are running a little tight. Makovich saying it's the 6-month interview process that takes a toll on applicants.
Our most recent hiring process started in September and they didn't start until January. It's difficult to find people that meet all of those qualifications and can also pass the testing and wait an extra 2 or 3 months until the actual start date because of that extensive background process.
And even though they're running short, workers say they've learned to work with what they've got.
Like, even if it gets like really crazy, everybody will just go through the questions that they need to ask and make sure that they're getting all the important information and then try and get as quickly to the next person as possible.
Hoping to have those extra 14 people helping out in the coming months. In Abilene with coverage you can count on, Jessica Rank, KTAB News.
Thank you, Jessica. Betty says the shortage is not affecting response times, making sure she has the minimum number of staff each shift, even if that means working overtime.